Bam! Mr. True, in this video, we're going to be introduced to the idea of a second derivative, finding it implicitly. Okay, now how are we going to do that? Well, we're just going to take the derivative of both sides of the equation with respect to x, like we've been doing for this entire section. So we're going to take the derivative of the left-hand side and the right-hand side. The derivative of x squared with respect to x is going to be bring the power down, reduce the power by 1. And I'm going to go ahead and show the chain rule for every single term here, even though in this case, like with the derivative of the inside function, in what's inside the power of 2, which is x, take the derivative of the inside function with respect to x. Well, that dx over dx is going to cancel. That's why there's no x prime. On the second term, we're going to bring the power of 2 down, so 2y, then to the first, paying attention to what is inside that power of 2, and finishing the chain rule, we're going to take the derivative of y with respect to x. So if you hadn't caught on yet, that's why we have a y prime and not y, and why we don't have any x primes when we're dealing with equations that involve variables of x and y, and we're taking the derivative with respect to x. On the right-hand side, we have the derivative of a constant one more time is equal to 0. So we have 2x plus 2y, y prime is equal to 0. Subtracting both sides by 2x, we have 2y, y prime is equal to negative 2x, and ultimately we have a y prime is equal to negative x over y. Great. That's step one. And nothing maybe necessarily very interesting there. Step two, we are asked to find a second derivative implicitly. So we're going to, you know what? I'm going to shift back to the derivative of y with respect to x. And we're going to use that notation, dy over dx instead of y prime, for our second derivative. So on the left-hand side, one more time, we're going to take the derivative with respect to x of, on the left-hand side, our dy over dx. And we're going to be taking the derivative with respect to x of our right-hand side, which is, again, negative x over y. When you look at the notation of a second derivative, the little exponent of 2, if you're not using like a y double prime notation, it shows up in different places on that notation. Well, think about what we have here, the derivative of y with respect to x. And now we're going to come along and apply another derivative with respect to x. Well, it appears that we have like a d times d. So our second derivative notation is going to be kind of like d squared y. And in the denominator, we have a dx times dx. Leibniz, the mathematician that created this notation, made this notation that we're using in a lot of calculus to make it easier to use the proper notation by, if it looks like multiplication, if it looks like division, that's how the notation acts, even though it's really about the notation of the calculus and not really maybe truly like multiplication and division. So we have dx over dx times dx is that dx squared. So there is how you write, if you will, y double prime in that expanded notation, d exponent of 2y over dx squared. And on the right hand side, we have, of course, the derivative of a quotient. So that's going to be low. So y d high, the derivative of negative x with respect to x is going to be negative 1 minus high, or the numerator, so minus negative x d low, the derivative of the denominator. Well, so let's just write this as a y prime. We'll use it as, we'll write dy over dx all over the denominator squared. Now, you'll never be allowed to write a second derivative equation with a first derivative notation in your final answer. So we need to get out the dy dx. We need to remove that first derivative notation and replace it with what it's equal to. So that's one reason why we're doing this video. Lots of students will incorrectly leave first derivative notation in a second derivative answer, and that is generally not going to be desirable. So we have y double prime, I'm going to go back to that notation. We have a negative y, negative times negative is positive, so negative y plus, now plus x. We're just going to do substitution, that's all we're doing. We're removing that notation of dy over dx or y prime and replacing it with what it's equal to, which is negative x over y. And then that is all over our denominator of y squared. Now there's a few ways you can do this. We can write negative y over 1 and find a common denominator. We can do something to eliminate the division of y in the numerator, which is the inverse math operation to division is multiplication. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show that I'm multiplying the numerator by y and the denominator by y and just do a little bit less work. Eliminate that division of y because I'm running out of board space, and we're going to distribute dy through both terms in the numerator and then distribute that or multiply that y to the denominator. And we have y double prime is equal to, well, negative y squared, as we have negative y times y. In our second term, the division of y and the multiplication of y are going to cancel, so our second term is just going to be minus x squared over y cubed. And that's great. We have a second derivative that doesn't have first derivative notation in it. Now, another reason why I chose this example, it's not a really terribly complicated example to introduce second derivatives. It's never a bad idea to introduce with a fairly simple example before it gets all nasty. Another thing is, this may very well be not one of the choices, say, on a multiple choice test. It might be quite a bit simpler looking. You see, if I take a negative 1, if I factor a negative 1 out of both terms in the numerator, we're going to have, and also doing your work horizontally is generally not a good idea, but I'm running out of space. I'm going to take a negative out and have y squared plus x squared over y cubed. Now, if I do that, do you see any any potential substitution? Like, why, if I have this sort of complex-ish fraction for my second derivative, maybe why are all my multiple choice answers so simple looking and maybe even have a number in it? X squared plus y squared is equal to 16. So it turns out here that when we go to write our second derivative, not only, and we have to do this, not only do we have to take out with substitution, remove that first derivative notation, but you might just find that the answer lends back and goes back to that original problem and also gives another opportunity for substitution. We're going to take out the x squared plus y squared and replace it with 16, because that's what it was defined to be equal to in the original problem. So our second derivative, y double prime, is equal to negative 16 over y cubed, and I hope that's enough to help you answer every second derivative question in your homework that is going to be finding that second derivative implicitly. I'm Mr. Tarrou. Bam! Go to your homework.